Awakening Truthers, and welcome to another video from A Plain Truth. Lasers, when they get around smoke, debris, can show, and you can see lasers, so let's dispel that myth. We've got climate refugees here in the United Statesians of America. Folks, climate refugees are coming from the East Coast, they're coming from the Southwest, and now California climate refugees. And look at that, 699, 66699 upside down. Here again, 666, they're telling us, the men in black. Here's the Three Stooges, the men in black telling us they're taking over paradise. Paradise is lost. We know it's a big gold mine underneath, and that's what they want it for. But I want to initially bring your attention to this picture here, the campfire. No storms ever go east. South, southeast, maybe coming from Alaska and from the north, but don't go south, southeast. Now look at that stream, folks. It streams straight across south, southeast towards the coast. The Sierra Mountains, 12,000 feet tall, would block any winds. That's why we don't have winds coming from the east. And we can show you here in a map. But first, look at this picture. Look at the way it dispersed. There was a big, huge line that was like a straw. And this straw piped right across, directly across, to hit Sonoma, Napa, and Mendocino counties and put us in a fog, a Tesla dome. They put us in a dome for days, and then now we got the rains coming. And you can see this is down in Malibu again. The smoke is going east. The west is on the coast. The cold air comes inland and creates the winds. That's why we have red flag warnings in the oceans. But look at this map about wind frequencies, and look at south, southeast you see here. There's not a lot of frequency. It's one of the lowest of the frequencies of weather coming from the south, southeast. The incidences of 25 to 30 is only 15, but it comes from the northeast, it's 1,527. So again, it doesn't make any sense what they're saying to us. They're lying. We know what they're doing to us now. We've waking up. And waking up, folks, you're not alone. I'm meeting so many people waking up. So it's really critical now that you open your hearts and open your homes and open your food and open your clothes and help who you can. Because sadly, what you're about to learn here and hear her is people that thought they had insurance to rebuild don't, and the homeless is going to grow. Climate refugees. So the forensics, the foreigner forensics experts, the coroners who are going into the paradise where the whole entire town was destroyed, eliminated, burned out, torched. This is not normal to identify camp remains. The coroner faces round the clock challenge. This is not normal, Jin said Thursday. Their staff worked alongside coroners officials who have streamed in from other offices around the state. I've been here 19 years, and we've never seen anything even close to this directed energy weaponry. I think the most we had was maybe 5 victims. That's easily manageable. This is what we train for all the time, but until you get in, you don't know how it really is. No doubt. And here we read just the other day after the tragedy up in Paradise that once again, they've been setting this meme for a while, but Governor Moonbeam Jerry Brown in his last acts is saying, oh, we got to clear out more of the forest to prevent the trees from causing the fires that allegedly the Pacific Gas and Electric power lines fell on the trees, which fell on the ground, which created 2,500, 3,000 degree temperatures, flipped cars on their roof, and burned out the entire 27,000 population of Paradise. I kid you not. So this is the full story. I'm not going to get into it, but you can see where this is all heading. So where are they heading? They're heading to the road, folks. I can't tell you how many people I have spoken to recently that are saying they're getting out and they're buying an RV and they're going on the road, or they have gone on the road. This is the new climate refugees in the United States. We're mobile people, so they're buying RVs. I just look at this picture of Trump with his hand on his daughter's breast. What's that about? Anyway, November 16th, people on the road. I've talked to several people recently who are either in RVs and living with their babies and traveling, or they're looking for money to finance getting an RV. But with rents going through the roof and now with the homeless population increasing dramatically, they are talking about 1 million Americans live full-time in recreational vehicles because they can't afford other options. This is the new climate refugee world we are facing. I'll put this article in the show notes. You can read it as well. And then in these camps here in Paradise, at the Paradise shelters where they're at the Walmart, Sam Walton, more than 140 campfire evacuees at shelters have contracted the norovirus, some acutely ill. 41 are currently experiencing symptoms, according to Butte County sources. So what are they doing? They're inoculating them, folks. They get everybody around, and they're lost their homes, and they go around and give them the vaccinations. Got to vaccinate everybody. Got to get them all vaxxed. Just a sidebar here down south. Don't forget the guys still marching towards the border, allegedly, and they're piling up in Tijuana, apparently. That's going to be another meme coming up here. Trump just said, we're going to use violence. We're going to use force against these people who are allegedly coming to come to the United States because they have nowhere else to go. Yeah, right. But this is in store for all of us, folks. Remember the Walmart in Texas where they used them to store to have the girls, the 1,500 girls that were not allowed. They separated from their parents and they put them in the Walmart camps and treated them horribly so that many have not even made it back. I'm sure they were harvested for many reasons. Now they're going to use force, and this is coming our way. All right, so what else? Well, the other problem is insurance. It's going to be hard to come by Californians. This is from a realtor. Recently, a home buyer called a realtor in Paradise to contact her State Farm agent, 40-plus years, to obtain homeowner's insurance on a manufactured home she was purchasing. She couldn't find coverage. This is before the fires. We as the realtors are fully aware of the extreme fire hazards. More and more companies are refusing to write policies for fear of increasing their liability in a large fire. But as new home buyers find out, many large companies have stopped writing new policies in Northern California. And if that wasn't bad enough, California's drought added to the picture, cut water usage by 2022 by 25 to 30%. That's in our headlights coming up. And it's finding it very hard to insure. Insurance hampers Sonoma County fire victims. Again, this is another story. Personal story. We need to tell personal stories. This is happening. Well, I used to have USA coverage until the fires hit in Santa Rosa last year, and I canceled it. This is the military, man. They're supposed to be taking care of our own. Not. 2 weeks before, they changed their software, their policies for coverage on homeowners, 2 weeks before the fires here in California, and the worst coverage you could possibly have is USAA. Cancel your homeowner's insurance. There's nothing insured about you. There's no safety for your homes. I'm going to show you why. Nick's answered the questions posed by his carrier in an online form to determine coverage for his 3-bedroom house. He bought it in 2013 for $5.5 million and valued it around $800,000, but the digital calculator said he only needed about $300,000 for coverage. So he answered the questions honestly. I believe it was a product that sufficiently covered me on a total loss. Well, isn't this what the insurance companies to see if you're covered? Isn't it what their job is and why you pay them money every month? So that they can make sure you have enough coverage for exactly this type of event? Well, guess what? 97% of people who had homeowners insurance coverage in the area here in Sonoma County do not qualify for insurance. First, they came in with FEMA and said, you have to sign over your property to FEMA, your insurance. You have to sign it over because FEMA has to scrape your dirt. And they're going to negotiate with your insurance companies before you. So everybody, I think there was a few that held out. But if you held out and did not sign up to FEMA to negotiate with your insurance company, the city would go and clear your property and bill you on their own. That's what they said if you don't sign up. They strong-armed everybody. But Deborah Tavares and I went to the Veterans Administration Center. We tried to talk to people lost homes to tell them not to sign. They didn't want to talk to us. So he's rebuilding his home cost $325,000 more than his insurance policy covered, and that doesn't even include paying off the mortgage. So what James Lee Witt from FEMA, who Clinton's old buddy who came over here to rebuild North Bay, is FEMA will take the 20% or whatever off for their clearing of the land. They will give federal money to help the insurance companies. They will negotiate with insurance companies, but the mortgage has to be paid off first. So after clearing, after the mortgage, there's nothing left for you to buy and rebuild your home. Consumers are blaming insurance companies, saying they were misled. They believe they had adequate coverage. Insurance companies contend that consumers are responsible for finding how much insurance they buy. Bullshit. That's your job. Oh, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. We're on your side. Now we know they're not. It's all lies. So this is 70% of local fire victims believe they don't have enough insurance. It's more like 97%, according to a survey by United Policyholders, a San Francisco-based consumer group. Nobody is looking out for your best interest, Nick tearfully recounted in an interview. He has decided to sell his lot to a builder for $265,000 in a deal scheduled to close on Monday. They sold me half a policy. He's lost all his investment in the property, and he is not alone. Fire-struck homes becoming uninsurable. It's a new theme. The California's wildfires of 20 worst wildfires. It's a record $12.5 billion in insurance claims. If they don't pay it out, guess what they get to keep? Profit, folks. It's all profit because they're not paying anybody out. So after last year's fires, United Policyholders, an advocacy group, heard from homeowners who received letters from their insurers stating that coverage would end in 45 days. So after they lost everything, they canceled their coverage. The group set to work with regulators and lawmakers on a legislative package that have required insurers to seek state approval before pulling out of high-risk areas. The only provision that became law was a two-year moratorium barring insurers from dropping policyholders for 2 years after a, quote, covered disaster. Insurers also stepping up, homeowners inspectors, she said, sometimes disqualifying houses with risks they had not cared about before. When that happens, the owner must try to find coverage elsewhere, possibly from a non-admitted insurer, one that does not meet the state's regulatory standards. That can be risky if all else fails. They can get insurance from California's property insurer of last resort, the FAIR Plan. You know what the FAIR Plan is? Check the... Florida had its equivalent of the Camp Fire in 1992. The storm wiped out a dozen insurance companies. The big insurers mostly pulled out of the state, and in retrenchment that followed, Florida set up its own homeowners insurance. Now, what is a state insurance regulator for if he doesn't help us file our claims? Where's the state insurance regulator supposed to make sure these guys play by the rules? Non-freaking-existent, because they're all on the same team. But it first filled a gap in the market. Citizens was not required to match its rates to its risks and ended up underpricing the remaining insurers. Citizens had a quarter of the homeowners insurance market in Florida. It's now down to about 5% and functions more as an insurer of last resort. Hill, the Hoover researcher, said she wondered whether the wildfires would force California to expand the FAIR Plan, even subsidize it with state money. But Florida's experience has left the industry wary of public enterprise. It's called the yo-yo market. Yo-yo, you're on your own. So you should only self-insure. You know, and one more point I want to make on all this is they've got the people that have lost everything in a vice, their property. Well, guess what? Insurance doesn't cover terrorist acts. So if you pipe up and say, hey, this was a terrorist act, they'll go, hey, that's great. Your policy's null and void. They've got us going both ways. But it's really critical to understand here, folks, that Governor Moonbeam Jesuit Brown is saying these fires are going to get worse. They're going to get more intense. That's what this article is about, that they're going to be increasing. And so if they're going to be increasing, because we know it, because we're causing it, because we're doing it, we need the Agenda 21. There's just too many people in Northern California, Bohemian Grove. We need our redwoods. We need our space. There's just too many of you near Satan's Rose here in Santa Rosa. So they're going to clear it out. But they're going to log it. They're going to burn us. They're going to flood us. Oh my gosh, folks. I wish it was different. I can't believe I'm even saying these words, but it is what it is. All right. So what's going to happen here in California is they're requiring solar panels now on all new homes built. They're saying in Santa Rosa, Moonbeam, or just passed a new law that says the homes here must be all electric, no gas. And this is getting into what I'm talking about, being up in the platforms, up in the sky, bringing our power down for our cars, Wi-Fi energy, 5G Wi-Fi energy, and our cars, our energy homes with solar panels. It's all going to be powered from platforms up in the sky. And this is possibly why they're doing all these cloud cover, these phase Tesla domes, which we're going to get into here. So as Americans, United Statesians, that's what we should be calling ourselves, United Statesians, we're going mobile. We're climate refugees. We need to open our homes. We need to open our hearts. We need to open our wallets. We need to open our clothes and our closets that we don't need. And we need to find distribution systems. We need to self-insure. We need to come together and form co-ops. We need to trade, barter, swap. We need to get out of the taxation system, which is slavery. So this is an opportunity for us to help others. This is an opportunity for to redefine who we are, to set up our own local economies. I call it the look, touch, and feel economy. We need to open our places to others that have been lost and are lost. They're normal people. This could happen to you. They hit in Fountain Grove. Those are high income, medium to high income homes they hit in here in Santa Rosa. No one is safe. They have our IP addresses. They can torch any home. And one more thing to dispel is everybody's talking about the smart meters causing these fires. That's bullshit. 97-98% of all homes have smart meters. Some got hit, some didn't. Another thing, I was talking with a lady who does really good investigative work, Alana Freeland. She's got a great book about the space fence being put over us. She was talking to people in Paradise who were off the grid, had their own supplies, not connected to any power, yet they still got torched. No 5G, no smart meters, nothing like that. So we're finding out that your credit cards with your chip in it has an RFID chip in it, and that's how they can track you through your credit card that has a chip in it. Remember, chips just got in the past couple years? It's so devious. It's so mind-blowing how they can do this, but we have the power. They are afraid of us. They hide in the dark. We're the light bearers, so we must shine our light, and we must reach out to our brothers and sisters who have lost everything. There's a lot of people living in fear right now. There's a lot of people waking up right now. We need to reach out to them. All you truthers that are listening to me, the awakening truthers, don't be fearful. Don't feel like you're alone. More and more are waking up. Truth is on our side, and we need to speak our truth, but we need to reach out, and we also need to design new visions of much, much better ways. What do you want to see? What will you fight for? Who can you help? Where can you be of assistance? This is empathy. This is compassion. And when we start on this path, our angels will come to help us. So know you're protected. Know that you got help, but you must reach out to others now. So here's to all of us, the awakening truthers. We're the leaders of the new change that has to happen. And we are the change that we must see. Tag, you're it. All right, we're going to leave Mr. Trump and his grabbing his daughter's breast here for another time. We'll catch you next video. Thanks for listening. Plain Truth out.